Hello, 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 my YouTube friend. Today, I'm Lillian. So if you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do subscribe. God bless you. So today's topic is all about how I get a job in Ghana. So as a Nigerian going to Ghana, I cannot speak the language. I don't understand the language. You know, as a Nigerian going to Ghana, going to another man's land, I don't know anybody there. I don't have brother. I don't have sister there in Ghana. So my mother told me and my sister to go to Ghana, Sandy. So when I went there, I started looking for a job all over the place. But the condition of the job I found was not suitable for me. I don't like the job I found there. So when I went home, I started praying. I told my sister, we have to pray. So we started doing fasting and prayer, me and my sister, Sandy. We started doing fasting and prayer. So luckily for me, I found out that they are not building a job, a new job close to my house. So when I went there, I thank God I applied for that job. That was when I found KFC, my biggest dream ever. It's what really God sent. That job was really God. It was really God sent in my life. So when I went there, I applied for the job. And the boss told me that we should come and we should go home. They will call us. So when I went to, I said, God, I need this job. Oh, God, please help me. I need this job. Please let them call me. Oh, let them call me. I need a job. I said praying seriously with my sister Sandy. So they're doing prayers over there. They now write me a letter, say I should come for interview. So when I went for the interview, they told us we should write a text, which I did. We write the test. They said I will still go for a blood test again. I said, God, blood test again. Why? I said, because of the condition of the job there. It's a kitchen job. I'm going to work in the kitchen department. So we have to do blood tests. I said, okay, God, help me. So we now went for the blood test. They said, okay, after the blood test, they said we should go home and wait. They will call us back again. I said, God, please help me. I need a job. I'm in Nigeria. I cannot speak the language. I don't understand tree. I don't understand the language there. Okay, I started praying. I said, God, I need a job. Let them call me for the job. I need it badly. I thank God. Luckily for me, they write me a letter. They say, I should come and start the job. I should come for the job. I said, oh God, I'm so happy. I was so happy. That was when I found KFC. I was really, really happy. The excitement, I was just jumping and shouting. I called my sister, said, God, they have called me for the job. I started shouting. I started thanking God. I was so excited. I was really, really excited when they called me for that job. So when I started the job, one, I didn't know I cannot speak three. I don't even hear the language. My colleague there, they are so nice. I just thank God for making me to have good colleagues there. My colleagues, they are so nice. They started teaching me the language. They started speaking three for me. They speak three for me. The one I don't understand, they will teach me. So that was how, and the colleague was so nice. The Ghanaians, they are so nice. You know, when you have not gone to a country before, so many people are talking bad of Ghanaians. But when you have not gone to a country, I advise you to go there and see things for yourself. See things for yourself so that you know that, yeah, what these people are saying, right, is true or that it's not true. This Ghanaian, they are really nice. They are like the people there I just met. They are so nice to me. My colleague, they are so nice. They teach me so many things in the job. They didn't discriminate me. They give me that free ass. They take me like their own sister. They teach me so many things there in that job. The boss was nice. My colleague was nice. Sometimes they give me the asset to go to the market. They give me money. I handle cash. They give me money. I go to the market. I buy things. I cook. I started doing a lot of things there in the job. Sometimes they put me in the cash session. I handle cash. I talk to customers. I sell for customers. And it was really nice. I feel welcome in that job. I feel like I was at home in that job. The welcome was really great. I feel welcome in that job. I feel like I was at home in that job. And the boss was so nice. I said I would do a resident permit. I said, oh God, resident permit again. How am I going to do that resident permit? I don't know anybody there. You know? I said, I have to do that resident permit for them to permanent me in that job. So I have to do the resident permit so that they can permanent me in the job. I said, okay, God, help me. Oh, I don't know anybody here for resident permit. Oh. So the boss said, no problem. He is going to help me. The boss now writes a letter for me. So I should go and give the immigration people. So after the boss gave me the letter, he read the letter for me. So I should go and give the immigration. I started processing. my permit there in Ghana. The boss check all through. The boss, my boss, Mr. Ken, was just checking on all what I'm doing, checking on the process till I get that resident permit there in Ghana. And I so thank God for giving me, for sending that man, Mr. Ken, to me as a godsend, my boss, as a godsend to me in that job. God really bless you, Mr. Ken, wherever you are. And that I was really determined in that job. When I mean determined, I put all my best. I put all my best in that job. I was really determined. Before I know, I got promoted in that job. They gave me the best worker, Lillian Ogene, the best worker in KFC. This is my certificate. They gave me even the best worker in KFC. I was so happy. I was really, really the excitement of that day. Oh God, it was like a dream come true in my life. I didn't even expect it. As a Nigerian going to another man's land, where you don't have any brother, you don't have any sister, become the best worker in KFC, Ghana. I was the excitement. My God, it was. I started jumping. I rolled on the flight. I just thank God for sending this job to me. This is today. Anyway, I see a Ghanaian, I always take them like my own sister because of that love that they showed to me in this job. That love, that impact was still there. That impact, that love, I treat them like my own sister. May that say why. God bless you, my Ghanaians. I love you. In this job, I really save. Oh. I save money. When because the pay was really nice there. The pay was really nice. I save money. I worked 2 years in KFC. Because I'm working two shifts. I'm working morning and evening, night shift. Sometimes when I was going home, sometimes I close, I walk around, let me say 6 to 2 a.m. in the night. And one thing I love about Ghana, I love the peace there in that country. The peace. When I'm going home around that 2 a.m. in the night to midnight, nobody harass me because my house is not too far to the job. I trek. Nobody harass me on the way. I walk majestically with my bag. I will just be walking. Going home, nobody harass you on the way. I walk peacefully. I go home peacefully. That is one thing I love about Ghana. I love the peace there in that country. I love the peace. And the country was so beautiful. I miss that place. Today, when I want to leave that job, I said, no, let them keep that space for my sister, my junior ones, or anybody that is coming. Let them keep that space. When I left that, I even write them a letter. I say, please, let them keep that space. All of them was it pained them when I leave that job. Because when I was going, I tell them, I want to go. I want to leave this country. That is when I come to Europe. I say, I want to go another land again. Let me show you the part where I'm working there. Can you see? This is the kitchen department where I'm working in KFC. And this is me. When my uniform and my cap. this is me too. May that say why. Oh my God, I love you all. God bless you.